Hi, everybody. This is Michael Disser from Click, and I want to spend a few minutes talking to you about data replication. Okay, so let's start by talking about some of the typical issues that data replication addresses. So everybody's talking about data. Everybody wants data these days. All these users over here, they want data. And then on this side, you have all the different types of repositories with all the data in them. And to get data from some of these repositories, not a big deal. As many users as you want can pull data out of the repository. But some of these repositories, the owners of them, they might be saying, no way, too many people, too many queries to my data source. It's going to really affect performance. It's really going to affect the overall performance of the system. So what's needed is something in between. And typically, these days, it's a cloud data warehouse. And so what happens is now is you pull the data from all these different repositories into this cloud data warehouse. And then these users are pulling the data from there. So that's, in essence, what we're talking about in data replication. Now, it can be pretty simple. If this is, for example, a relational database over here, and it's a relational database in the center here, that's pretty simple to replicate. But what about if perhaps you have a mainframe type system, or perhaps you have some type of custom system that only your organization has ever built, or you maybe have some complex enterprise application like SAP. Replicating that type of information is much more complicated, so it's important to keep in mind what you're replicating from and that you have the tools to replicate from all these different types of repositories. The other thing to keep in mind is that when you are populating this cloud data warehouse, it's really two things. One is the initial population of that database, but then how do you keep it up to date? How do you keep all these different repositories when a change happens over here? How do you make sure that's reflected in that cloud data warehouse as soon as possible? And so that's important because historically, this type of update has happened more on a nightly basis, and that's not very real time. These users, they want data as soon as possible, as real time as possible. So you really want some more type of real time replication, something like CDC, change data capture. And so that really will make, when a transaction happens over here, it will immediately be reflected in this cloud data warehouse. The other thing to keep in mind is that once you have this cloud data warehouse here, you can do a lot more with it. You can maybe not just replicate, but maybe you can transform the data. Maybe you can do a catalog of data. So now these users over here can look at the catalog and make it very easy for them to pick the data they want. So it's a lot more that you can do with data replication. But the important thing is that by having this in the center here, now all your users over here, they're happy, they can get data as much as they want. And by not affecting the performance of these systems over here, your DBAs are also happy too. Okay, so that's data replication. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.